Good evening, Irving. Hello, hello. How was your day? Let me see. I cannot listen to you. Hi, how was your day? Do you have problems to connect?
I'm fine, a little bossy, but fine.
Okay.
So,
And how is your daughter?
I mean, yeah, she's running around the house.
How old is she?
She is 2 years old.
2 years old. Yes, you already have told me. You cannot stop her anymore.
Then
But at this hour, she is supposed to go to bed.
yeah, suppose.
Yes, you have to set your rules with her, because later you cannot make her. You have to teach her in early years.
Yes.
What you don't teach her in early years, you cannot make her do it when it's older.
Yes.
Because most of the people say, no, the baby is small. He or she doesn't understand.
Muscle is
They are
easy.
intelligent. They are
They're very
intelligent.
intelligent.
We are the ones
Yeah.
that don't understand them.
Yes,
Nosotros
we
somos
are.
los que no los entendemos.
Yes, they are very
Hi,
intelligent.
Omar. Good evening. I remember I trained my children since they were in my womb. Desde que estaban en mi vientre, les puse reglas. They always want to be in a way, and during the day, it doesn't matter to me, but at night, when I have to go to sleep, I cannot be on my side because they were in a way that I cannot hold them. And I told them, please put your head, and I touched their head, put your head here and your feet here, and let me sleep, because that way I cannot sleep. And they move, and they move. So they understand since they were in the womb. And
Yes.
when they already were born, I talked to them as they were grown up, and they understand. But we tend to say they don't understand. Of course, they understand. We are the ones that do not know them, because there is a book that is called The Little Tyrants, o sea, Los Pequeños Tiranos, and it's
Yeah.
about how the babies control the parents. And
Most of them. Yes.
it's true, and we let them,
You
but
let them.
we have to set the rules since they are very little. And then when they grow, they know what they can do and what they cannot do. Because when they get older, they say, I had my rights, I will call the police. But if they already know what they can do and what they cannot do, then they don't menace you with that.
Because, yes.
Okay, let's see. Today is Monday, our class 13. And we are going to talk about present continuous, okay? Now, Omar, can you read the thought for today, please?
Leaving to employer needs to change to be perfect. To change often.
Okay. To improve is to change. To be perfect is to change often. Okay. O sea, mejorar es cambiar. Y ser perfecto es cambiar a menudo. Winston Churchill. Hay gente que lo detestaba a él, a mí me agradaba. Tenía cosas. Well, everybody has positive and negative things. Okay? But you have to get focused on the positive things and try to make them to be part of you. Okay? And this is what we were talking about. Okay? The spelling rules for the present participle, gerund, or ing form. Okay. Have you worked with them? ¿Estuvieron trabajando con ellos y la lista de verbos que ustedes tienen? I hope so. Because the only way to learn is practice. Okay. And then here it says, we use the present continuous to talk about things happening now, to describe an action in progress. Where is John? In his room. He's doing his homework. You're speaking too fast for me. Okay? Now, Irving Uriel, may the question, please.
Where's John?
Okay, Omar, answer it. In his room. Omar? Answer the question. In his room.
In the room, he is doing his homework.
He is doing his homework, okay? Now, Miguel Antonio, next.
You are speaking too fast for me.
Excellent, thank you. Now, temporary activities. To describe a short-term or temporary situation. Uriel, number one, please.
We are learning about trees this week.
Okay, Omar.
My brother is staying with friends in London. He finished some years to life.
Until he finds somewhere to live. Until he finds somewhere to live. Repeat, please.
Until he finds somewhere to live.
Thank you. Now, situations of change. Okay, Miguel Antonio.
The hole in the ozone layer is getting bigger.
Okay, the hole in the ozone layer is getting bigger.
The ozone layer is getting bigger.
Uriel.
The number of pupils in the school is falling.
Okay, thank you. Now, Omar, future arrangements.
We're flying to Spain on a school trip next month.
On a school trip next month.
On a school trip next month.
Okay. Gabriel.
I'm seeing the health teacher of their class.
Excellent. Now, present continuous or present simple. Sometimes we don't know which to use, okay? And here it says when we have to use each of the sentence, okay? It rains a lot in Scotland. It's an habitual situation. Then this is? ¿Es presente simple o presente continuo?
Simple present.
Simple present, okay?
Simple present.
Now, Omar. Put on an anorak. It's raining. It's raining. ¿Qué sería esto? ¿Present continuous o present simple?
Present continuous.
Present continuous. Excellent. Miguel Antonio. Read number three, please.
Sightings do experiments to test their theories.
Theories.
Theories. Theories.
Uh-huh. Always true. Okay.
Always
so true. This is simple present or present continuous?
Simple present.
Excellent. Now, Gabriel Ortega.
He speaks French and German.
Okay. Then this is present continuous or simple present?
Simple present.
Okay. Now, Irving.
Wait a minute. She's speaking to someone or her mobile.
Mm-hmm. Or her mobile. Okay.
Her mobile.
This is present continuous or simple present?
Present continuous.
Okay, present continuous. Okay, if you know, if you notice, when you are talking right now, is in present continuous, things that are habitual situations, always true, or things that is happening currently, we use simple present. But for things that are running right now, we use present continuous. And here are the different forms. Affirmative, negative, interrogative, and how do we use them, okay? Now, Irving, read the first sentence, please.
I am arriving at 2.
I am arriving at 2. Okay. Now, in negative.
I am not arriving at 2.
I am not arriving at 2. Now, interrogative.
Am I arriving at 2?
Excellent. Thank you. Now, Omar. Number two.
You are calling home.
Negative.
You are not calling home.
Interrogative.
You are calling home.
No. Interrogative.
Are you calling home?
Are you calling home? Excellent. Now, Miguel Antonio.
She is going to the movie.
Okay.
He isn't going to the movie. Is he going to the movie?
Excellent. Thank you. Now, Gabriel.
She helping the teacher? She is not helping the teacher. Is she helping the teacher?
Okay, thank you. Now, Uriel.
We are stopping the taxi. We are not stopping the taxi. Are we stopping the taxi?
Excellent. Omar.
You are watching to change jeans.
Jeans.
You are watching the jeans. You are not watching the jeans. Are you watching the jeans?
Excellent. Now, Miguel Antonio.
They are opening that door. They aren't opening that door. Are they opening that door?
Excellent. Okay. Any questions about how we form the present continuous? ¿Cuál es el auxiliar del presente continuo?
Is and are.
Verb to be. El verbo to be. ¿Ok? Es el verbo to be que le corresponde a cada persona. And when do we use the verb to be as an auxiliary in present continuous?
Sorry?
When do we use verb to be as auxiliary in the present continuous? Just for negative, just for interrogative, or just for negative and interrogative, or in all of them? Affirmative, okay. Negative, interrogative.
Okay.
¿Cuándo se usa el verbo to be como auxiliar?
En todas.
En todas. O sea, la diferencia que les decía yo entre el presente simple y el presente continuo. Que en el presente simple utilizamos los auxiliares solamente cuando estamos hablando en negativo y en interrogativo. ¿Verdad? En afirmativo no se usa. No se usan auxiliares. Pero en el caso del presente continuo, sí, el auxiliar se ocupa tanto en afirmativo como negativo e interrogativo. ¿Verdad? Bien. Entonces aquí hay una excepción. Ok. Uriel, read it, please. No está. Gabriel.
There are a section. There are some verbs that we never use
there
in the present
continuous. There are some
continuous.
Verbs that we never use in the present continuous.
Okay. Because they are states and cannot have a progressive form. These verbs are preferences and state verbs such as known, have, like, el have for possession, o sea, tengo, El have for possession. Like, love, prefer, hate, want, believe, own, cost, for this and similar verbs, we use simple tenses. O sea, no se usan en forma progresiva, sino que se usan en simple tenses. Okay. The present continuous for the future. O sea, también podemos utilizar el presente continuo para referirnos a situaciones en el futuro. Okay. When we talk about a fixed event in the future, we often use the present continuous. It's particularly common when you refer to appointments in your agenda. For example, Uriel.
I am going to the dentist on Tuesday at 10 a.m.
Thank you. Omar.
We are meeting my sister for lunch today.
Miguel Antonio.
He's having a haircut this afternoon.
Okay, Gabriel.
What time are you leaving?
Irving.
They are taking the 7 o'clock train.
Okay. If you notice, those are events that will happen. Okay, so they are future events. But since they are a fixed event in the future, we use the present continuous. When you are sure whether to use, when you are not sure whether to use the present simple or the present continuous, ask yourself these questions. Is it a long-term situation? If so, use present simple. Is it a state verb, for example, like? If so, use the present simple. O sea, eso es lo que tenemos que tener en cuenta. O sea que estos verbos sabemos que no van a ir en presente continuo. Entonces, apréndanse que esos verbos no van a ir en presente continuo. Que si es una situación a largo, o sea, habitual o que es siempre verdadera, o que son cosas, facts que son de siempre, o sea, que no, cosas que no cambian. Entonces eso va a ir en presente simple. Is it an action verb happening in this moment? If so, use the present continuous. O sea, los verbos que van a ir en presente continuo son action verbs. O sea, son verbos de acción. Is it an action verb that is a temporary situation? If so, use the present continuous. Is it a fixed plan in the future? If so, use the present continuous. Entonces aquí están los diferentes momentos en que ustedes van a usar presente continuo y presente simple. O sea, esto para el presente simple y esto es para el presente continuo. As you can see, we use these two sentences in many daily situations. So, they are really useful to learn as well as you can. Try to practice them a lot until they become natural and pay special attention to the third person singular. Ahí está malo. Ahí es singular. Because it will really make a difference if in your accuracy in conversation. Okay. Acuérdense que la tercera persona singular es la que vamos a aplicar de que a la mayoría se le pone S, los verbos que terminan en S, SH, CH, X, O, eso se le agregan ES, los que terminan en Y precedidos por una consonante, se cambia la Y por I latina y se le agrega ES, ¿verdad? Y esas son las reglas para tercera persona de singular. Entonces, tenemos un, ahí al WhatsApp les mandé un quiz para practicar lo de, les mandé un quiz para practicar en el WhatsApp, denle clic ahí. Y entonces aquí lo tenemos. Vaya, present simple and present continuous. On Fridays, we usually early. On Fridays, we usually early. Sería finish or are finishing.
Finish.
Finish, okay. Now, number two, Omar.
Today we are finishing late because of a meeting.
Okay, excellent. Porque es algo que está sucediendo ahorita, que es fuera de lo habitual. Now, Miguel.
She's coming.
My best friend. My best friend
is called
Daniel.
Daniel.
She.
She's coming.
¿Estás seguro? Vale, le vamos a poner is coming. ¿Los demás qué dicen? She comes from France or she is coming from France?
She comes.
She comes from France, ¿verdad? O sea que ella es francesa. Viene de Francia. Daniel. Gabriel
is coming
to visit me today, ¿verdad? O sea, es como algo que tienen agendado. Uriel.
They have a warehouse outside the city.
Excelente. Acuérdense que have es de los que no pueden ir en presente continuo. ¿Verdad? Es de la lista que les di que no pueden ir en presente continuo. ¿Ok? El have de tener, de posesión. ¿Ok? Omar.
They are having a break.
They're having a break. Vale. En este caso, podría ser porque no se refiere a posesión, sino que como cuando decimos they are taking a shower o they are having a shower, ¿verdad? Okay. Miguel.
This evening, my boyfriend and I go to a concert.
Go or are going? This evening. Es como en futuro.
This is are going.
Are going, okay. Now, Gabriel.
I normally go out with my friends on Saturday evening.
Sí, porque es normally, o sea, es un hábito, ¿verdad? Es en presente simple. Uriel.
I take a shower when I get back home.
Sí, es algo habitual, ¿verdad? Omar.
We are making a quiz.
We are making a quiz, porque es algo que está sucediendo ahorita, ¿verdad? Pues lo vamos a enviar a ver cómo salimos. Hey, 10 de 10, estamos bien. Ok. Vale, lo vamos a ir leyendo uno por uno. Primero Omar, después Miguel, después Gabriel y después Irving, en ese orden.
On Friday, we usually finish early.
Okay, next.
Today we're finished late because of meeting.
Finishing
late because of meeting.
Okay, thank you. Next.
My best friend is called Daniel. She come from France.
Okay.
Daniel is coming to visit me today.
Okay.
They have a warehouse outside the city.
Thank you. Next.
They're having a break.
Excellent.
This evening, my boyfriend and I are going to a concert.
Okay, next.
I normally go out with friends on Saturday evenings.
Okay.
I take a shower when I get back home.
Excellent. And the last one?
We are making a quiz.
Okay. Good. Any questions about the present continuous?
No.
No?
What is the meaning of warehouse?
Warehouse es como un lugar donde guardas cosas.
Una bodega.
Ajá, como una bodeguita, ajá. Warehouse.
Just this.
Normalmente hay gente, digamos, que como que no le alcanza el espacio en las casas o en los apartamentos donde viven y rentan lugares donde van a dejar cosas. No sé si ustedes alguna vez han visto en el History Channel que salen como depósitos, lugares que están así, que parecen como garage, pero que hay varios así, uno a la par del otro, y como que los como que
luego
los
subastan.
dan como a oferta, o sea que la gente los paga a lo que sea y lo que tenga ahí adentro es de ellos. Es por ejemplo cuando la gente ha dejado de pagar esos lugares o se han muerto y no le dejaron a nadie, nadie sabía que tenían esa bodega, entonces ya nadie se siguió pagando, entonces ellos, para no estar perdiendo dinero ahí, entonces lo subastan y recogen dinero de la subasta, ¿verdad? sin saber qué es lo que hay allá adentro. Entonces, el que lo compró, suerte de él si hay cosas con valor ahí o si no hay cosas con valor, ¿verdad? Entonces hay algunos que sacan muy buenas cosas de ese tipo de bodegas, ¿verdad? Hay otros que no, que dicen que es pérdida, ¿verdad? Pero ahí es a la suerte. Hay algunas veces que encuentran hasta cajas fuertes, ¿verdad? Con cosas adentro. Una caja fuerte no va a guardar zapatos sucios,
No.
¿verdad? Entonces, ahí la suerte de cada quien. Me imagino que han de tener algún tipo de permiso de parte de la ciudad de hacer eso cada cierto tiempo, ¿verdad? Porque no es cuestión de que lo van a hacer solo porque se les antoja. Porque sea como sea, eso era propiedad de alguien, ¿verdad? Entonces, pero como la gente es, cuando agarran esas bodegas, firman contrato. Entonces, si incumplen con el contrato, entonces ellos pueden hacer lo que quieran con esas bodegas. Y normalmente lo que hacen es que las subastan, ¿verdad? Pero todas las subastas y cosas así son cosas con permiso del gobierno. Ok. Entonces esas son warehouses. O sea, como bodeguitas donde van dejando cosas. Then you don't have problems with the present continuous. Le vuelvo a
No.
poner la La lámina esta. Tienen ahí sus listas de verbos para que practiquemos haciendo oraciones afirmativas, negativas, interrogativas y las intercambiamos entre nosotros.
Ahorita la buscamos.
¿Perdón?
Ahorita la busco.
Okay. Entonces, hagan una, así como hicimos la vez pasada, hagan sus propias oraciones y escogen a uno de sus compañeros para que se la cambie de forma. Ustedes la pueden hacer ya sea afirmativas, negativas o interrogativas y también pedir a sus compañeros que la transformen en cualquiera de las otras.
Okay.
¿Ya?
¿Los irregulares o los regulares?
De la que quiera. Solo asegúrese de que no sea ninguno de estos.
Los de.
¿Cuáles eran? Estos. Es más, deberían de poner alguna en la
Ajá.
lista de verbos, deberían de poner alguna cosita como para de que esos no pueden ser en presente continuo.
Aquí.
¿Ya? El que ya esté preparado, que empiece. ¿Prefieren hacer eso o prefieren hacer una lectura? Y les dejo para que tengan preparadas sus oraciones para mañana. Les estoy dando así gusto del cliente. Porque tengo preparada una lectura aquí también. Entonces, ¿qué prefieren? ¿Hacer la lectura o hacer este ejercicio con las oraciones?
Hagamos una ronda de las oraciones y luego nos pasamos a la...
Vaya, perfecto. ¿Ya tienes su oración? Ahí arriba están las fórmulas. Okay, go ahead.
I am learning English.
Excellent. Who in which form?
A question, Gabriel.
Are we learning English?
Good. Pero sería más,
Okay.
am I learning English? Pero está bien también la otra. Diga usted una suya, Gabriel.
I am calling my wife.
Okay.
Miguel in a negative.
¿Cuál era la oración?
I am calling my wife.
Negativo. I am not calling away.
Excellent. Now, tell us one of yours.
You are building a toy.
Building.
You are building a toy.
Más sería making.
Making.
Making. You are making a
You are
toy.
making a toy.
Okay. Who? In which form?
Omar, en interrogativo.
Omar, interrogative. You are making a toy.
Are you making a toy?
Excellent. Now, one of yours, please. Una de las suyas, Omar.
You are following the race.
You are following the
race.
Right.
Right.
¿Qué es eso?
Carrera.
Ah, the race. You are following the race. Okay. ¿Quién quiere que se lo cambie?
Uriel.
Miguel, ¿en qué forma?
Negative.
Negative.
Repítame la oración.
You are following the race.
En negative.
Yes.
You are not following the race.
Okay, now another one from you.
You are speaking English.
You are speaking English. Who in which form?
Gabriel.
Gabriel.
Negative.
Gabriel in negative.
You are not speaking English.
Excellent. Now, do you have other? Do you have other sentence? ¿Tiene otra oración para sus compañeros?
I am fixing my car.
Okay. ¿Quién quiere que se lo cambie?
Uriel.
Okay, which form?
Interrogative.
Interrogative form.
Am I fixing my car?
Excellent. Okay, do you have another one?
Yes. Are we meeting new people?
Are we meeting
new people?
New people.
Yes.
Okay. Who in which form?
Miguel in positive.
Vuélvasela a decir.
Are we meeting new people?
We are, I need the new people.
We are meeting new people. We are meeting new
we
people.
We are meeting the new people.
Okay, sin el da. We are meeting new people.
We are meeting new people.
Excellent. Do you have another one?
You are reading a book.
You are reading a book. Which form and who?
Auriel, interrogative. Irving, interrogative.
Are you reading a book?
Excellent. Do you have another one?
Yes. She is singing a beautiful song.
She is singing a beautiful song. Who and which form?
Omar in negative.
Omar in negative.
Permítamela, por favor.
She is singing A beautiful song. She is singing a beautiful song.
Como lo quiere, a negative.
Yes.
She starts singing a beautiful song.
Excellent. Okay. Now, do you have another sentence?
He is smart.
¿Dónde está el presente continuo?
No me equivoqué, entonces no era así.
Pues sí, arréglela. ¿Qué es lo que quiere decir?
Y he puesto ella es inteligente.
Podría decir getting. She is getting smart. Ya se está como volviendo inteligente. She is getting smart.
She is getting smart.
Ajá. Entonces, ¿quién quiere que se la cambie?
Irving.
¿Y a qué forma?
Interrogative.
Interrogative.
Getting smart.
Is she getting smart? Ok. Bien, si se fijan, ya están haciendo ustedes sus propias oraciones, ¿verdad? Y créanme, eso es lo que más cuesta, hacer las oraciones y esos cambios que están haciendo de forma y todo eso. Lo están haciendo y lo están haciendo muy bien. Congratulations. Bien. Entonces vamos con este que dice Dreams can come true. Hoy lo vamos a empezar de un solo sin que yo se los lea. Si nos equivocamos en algo, yo los corrijo en el camino, ¿ok? Do you know anyone who made a big change in his or her lifestyle? At the age of 40, Tom Block was the head of H&R Block, a huge company that helps people prepare their tax forms. Miguel, continue.
He was very successful. Successful.
Successful. Successful.
Successful. Although Bloch earning a lot of money, he wasn't very happy.
Okay. Continue. Usted va a decidir quién va a continuar.
Irving.
Okay.
Be happy. He spent too much time at work and didn't have enough time to spend with his family. Suddenly, he left H&R Block and became a teacher in a poor neighborhood.
Okay. Who continue?
And Gabriel.
I want to help people who didn't had the opportunity. I have blocked, explained, learned to control the students. What's her fears? But the rewards, helping children and hearing students say he's their favorite teacher, are great, and Blood is able to spend more time with his family.
Okay. Now, who continues?
Omar.
For 11 years,
creo que él tiene problemas con la conexión ahorita. For 11 years, Tom Neal worked as a lawyer, and his wife, Mel, worked as a teacher. They saved every penny they could. Irving. Quite el mute.
And sorry. Finally, they had no money to buy a boat. That was 70 years ago, and except for occasional stops, they have been at sea ever since. For the Neals and their two daughters, the difficulties of their lifestyles are very real. There's not much money, so meals are often rice and beans and fish.
Okay. Yes. Miguel?
Storms are dangerous, especially when the boat is far from land. But Tom neatly says overcoming dangers together as a family is one of the rewards of their ways of life. Another he say is saying the starfish on the bottom of the sea in the moonlight.
Okay, good. See you tomorrow. Try to finish section 5 and also the final test. Okay, the sooner the better. Tomorrow we will continue. Okay, bye bye. Take care.